I think this makes for a very diverse group here that we have. And for that, I think there are going to be extreme assets and advantages to learning from and with one another this semester. I think when it comes to diversity, in my opinion, many companies like Google and Facebook and Apple hire diverse minds and they put them at the table together to learn and to really problem solve longstanding issues in their respective fields. We need to be able to do a better job of that as educators, and I hope to be ushering that and being a fellow champion in that regard, again, learning from and with one another. I think this first week, as we dove deeply into universal design for learning, we're going to be mimicking some of those same strategies through giving you options to do video responses or audio responses or even textual responses or sometimes even pictorial responses as lived through the final project of sorts, as well as other activities each and every week as we go along this semester. As we dovetail into week two, you'll also notice that week two is all about policy and the sort of the history of the special education or exceptional children, if you will. And just to kind of give you a snapshot of that, just as an introduction, if you will, if we think about reading challenges in the field of literacy, which is my sort of expertise, reading comprehension or the struggles within reading comprehension specifically have only been separated from IQ for about 125 years now. So for the very end of the 1800s was the first time that an ophthalmologist was able to figure out that some people can have reading challenges but not have a low IQ, and that they're not synonymous, and that each and every one of us has different opportunities in terms of strength or challenges away along the way of K-12 and even in the college years and graduate study alike. And so it was really an important time to be able to figure out that people can have challenges and not be dumb. And so that was sort of the beginnings of trying to think through interventions and other kinds of accommodations and strategies for remediation to get people back on track. And I think that really bodes well for this class in particular, EDUC 514, where we're thinking about how do we support each and every child, and how do we treat them with incredible respect, knowing that they bring so much to the table, right? They have a wealth of diverse experiences that they've lived through. They have geographic knowledge sometimes better than ourselves. They have rich culture and language that is akin to their family and their place of origin. And all along the way, we're there learning with them, and we need to be able to treat them with uncanny compassion and respect, and as having worth and voice in our classroom. So I think this week, as we talk about the history of special education and educational policy that is linked to that, you'll see different iterations along the years. And oftentimes, they didn't always receive the benefit of the doubt and the proper care and respect and instruction that these children duly deserved. And so I think the onus is on us to continue to push that forward, knowing that it's still not where it needs to be, but it's definitely better than in years in the past. So I look forward to learning with each of you this week, and please let me know if you have any questions along the way. Take care.